You must have gone to the barber shop to get your hair cut. Have you noticed that when the haircut is done, the barber holds up a mirror behind you? Now let me tell you something interesting. When the barber was cutting your hair, he makes you sit in front of a large mirror. Now once the haircut is completed, he holds up another mirror behind you. With this mirror, you will find that you are able to see the back of your head. How are we able to see the back of our head? It's interesting, right? Let us find out how it is happening by getting into the science of it. When the barber is holding up another mirror behind your head, what is happening is the rays of light that are getting reflected from your head, after reflection, it is hitting this mirror. After these light rays hit this mirror, they are reflected again. After reflection from the mirror behind your head, they travel to the mirror in front of you. After these light rays hit the mirror in front of you, they get reflected and they enter your eyes. So what does this prove? This proves that reflected light rays can be reflected again. This is how we are able to see the back of our head with the help of a second mirror that the barber places behind our head. So let us find out more about how reflected light rays are reflected again. Now look at this picture closely. You must have been to an amusement park and gone into the mirror room. In that room, you must have seen several mirrors being kept parallel to one another. Now when two mirrors, plain mirrors, are kept parallel to one another, you will be able to see numerous images of yours, as you can see from this picture. Numerous images of yours will be formed. Now can you tell me why we see so many images when we stand in front of two parallel mirrors? There are almost an infinite number of images that we are able to see. Let us find out how we see so many images. Now consider an object placed in between two parallel plane mirrors, M1 and M2. Now when this object, or let's say you are standing in between these two parallel plane mirrors, your image will be obtained on both the mirrors. The image obtained on mirror M1 is I1, and the mirror M2 image is I2. Now once these images have been obtained, what do you think happens? Image I1 acts as a virtual object for mirror M2, and image I2 acts as a virtual object for mirror M1. So when image I2 is acting as a virtual object for mirror M1, another image will be formed over here. So we are getting image I3. That is the image of virtual object I2. Similarly, I1 acts as virtual object for mirror M2, and thus we get an image I4. So we obtain image I4, that is the image obtained due to virtual object I1. Now after we have obtained I3 and I4, what do you think happens? I3 acts as a virtual object for mirror M2 again, and I4 acts as a virtual object for mirror M1 again. Now once these images are acting as virtual objects, we'll obtain more images. So from image I3 and I4 acting as virtual objects, we obtain images I5 and I6. Now once we obtain these images, Again, these will act as virtual objects. So I5 acts as virtual object for mirror M2 and I6 acts as virtual object for mirror M1. And this process continues until we get numerous such images, I7, I8, and so on. So, due to successive reflections with these images acting as virtual objects for these two mirrors, M1 and M2, we are able to get infinite number of images when we stand in front of two parallel plane mirrors. So, taking a quick recap, what did we learn? We learned that reflected light can be reflected again. That is how we are able to see the back of our head when we visit the barber's shop and he holds up a mirror at the back of our head to show us how the haircut has been done. We also learned that when an object or we stand in between two parallel plane mirrors, numerous or infinite number of images are obtained. These images are obtained because images act as virtual objects for these respective mirrors. And these images keep on acting as virtual objects. And since this process is repeated, we obtain infinite number of images.